Welcome back, everybody. It is time for round four of our United States of Barbecue competition. So far, we named winners in three of the four cities in our barbecue bracket. Dallas, Washington, D.C., and Chicago.
Yep, we have indeed. And the winners of each round will come here to New York to compete in our grand finale on National Barbecue Day. That's next Monday, by the way. The winner will be crowned Gina May's ultimate pit master. Yeah. And take home $10,000. That's real. For our fourth and final city, we have to get Sam in on this. He is live in Tampa. He never says no to a live assignment in Florida. Sam, talk to us.
Never. No, I was on my way to Florida anyway, so here I am. Hey, the business of barbecue, let's get going. We are in this beautiful spot, by the way. I can't stop talking about these trees and the water behind us and everything. It's old McMicky's farm. This is Jacob. And Ralph is his dad. This is their spot right here. And they were nice enough to set us up. So everybody, a round of applause for them. We had to break for a wedding yesterday. So there's a lot of business going on here. Also, so let's get to it here. We've got two married teams that are up against it during the day today. Former Tampa Bay Buccaneer and former Bucks cheerleader Johnny and Pam Smith, who now run Jackie's Barbecue. I can't say Johnny Smith. I gotta say Johnny Ray Smith. That's what I gotta say. So, firefighter Anthony Fonseca and his wife Allison, a former teacher. Anthony, give me that big golden smile, my friend, right there. All right. And look, Captain Fear is here as well. So, everybody did the applause there. Let's introduce our judges, because we can't do this without them. Our WWE superstar, global ambassador, and fan favorite of the barbecue day, Titus O'Neil. Star chef of Tampa's Joe Toro, Joe Isidore, and by the way, opening a new restaurant, Arthur Jr.
June 1st.
Yeah. In New York, by the way, yeah. Derek Brooks, not only a former Tampa Bay Buccaneer, but I mean the list of your, I can't go through the list of all the wonderful things you did for Tampa Bay and all the awards and rings and things. Did you tell me something about Michael a little earlier as well?
Yeah, he's my Hall of Fame class.
Yeah, we've got three fine judges ready to set this off, and now everything went so perfectly the first 4 days of this competition. Let's just mess it all up today. But first, we'll roll that beautiful barbecue footage.
Here in the Sunshine State, it's new school versus old school.
There's a lot of old school around here, and we're here to take by storm.
Old school will always be the best school here.
The Fonseca family's Station House Barbecue, not even 2 years old, but still ready to fire up the competition. When Fireman Anthony isn't on shift at the station, he's calling the shots at Station House.
This is the best brisket in Tampa Bay.
And fellow firefighters love their cooking.
They always call me, hey, got any leftovers, got any food.
I'll even run them over food, and they'll meet me in between calls.
Their specialty, a 16-hour brisket. Top contender this morning.
Anybody can cook a brisket. They can cook it consistently on a daily basis, or it's always going to be fresh.
Down the street, a Tampa Bay institution, Jazzy's, run by the Smith family.
We've been here for 26 years, and that speaks for itself.
Johnny, a former Tampa Bay Buccaneer, and wife Pamela, a former cheerleader, passing the torch to their son, Caleb.
They're only going to get this at Jazzy's, man. I'm telling you.
And the Smiths, keeping Jazzy's menu all the same all these years.
When you get that good food, that beef from scratch, there's nothing like it.
Tampa is definitely a barbecue town. So we're going to start with the tasting. Judges are ready. With Jazzy's. Now, Jazzy's, Pam, Johnny Ray, you guys put together this beautiful beans and ribs. I mean, come on, this is gorgeous. So tell me why this is a number one plate.
Well, I grew up watching my grandfather cook, and we got this is pepper, seasoned salt, and this is the bomb. This is the makeup of it.
All right. Okay, well then, wait. Hey, go ahead. I'm just going to get a little of the bomb here. I want to try it. Go ahead.
We have our beans here that we make, and we slow cook them. And this is our special sauce that goes with the beans that we make. And that's the magic for the beans.
That's our magic for the beans, and that's the sauce.
We have our barbecue sauce that also goes in our beans.
That is
milk or water.
Oh, my God.
You know, hit me.
I feel the same way.
Yeah.
I'm a sauce guy.
Yeah, me
and
too.
This is
oh, man. He fell later. It's going to be fell.
You're the tough one to please, but now, Titus, I don't know that we have enough to feed you.
Right.
But what happened with Jazzy's?
Well, I can tell you, I mean, this is what happened. My face was naked. But the beans were tremendous, the ribs were tremendous, and the sauce was definitely hot. I just drank 2 gallons of water.
I know. We had to put extra water down. I'm not kidding. We had to put extra water down. All right, so now let's talk to Anthony and Allison. So, you guys, married for how long?
16 years.
Always the best.
Always the best move.
All right, now tell me a little bit about this, because there's something magical, I think, about brisket and coleslaw, and that's what you brought to the competition. So tell me about that combo.
Yes, we have USDA prime brisket right here. Smoked about 14 to 16 hours, depending on the size of brisket. We seasoned salt, pepper, and we have our own blend of our own seasoned salt that we use.
Awesome.
We also use pickle juice mustard. We kind of spread the mustard out so it's not so thick. And we pair it with our nice McMicky's slaw, which is nice and refreshing.
That looks so good.
It's got apples in it, green onions, and it pairs well.
Yeah, people miss out on the whole idea of slaw, but it's cooling, right?
Oh, yeah, very
it cools
very
down
cool.
that fire. All right, guys, so now, Tyson, I'm going to work backwards. Tell me about the brisket and the slaw.
Well, the brisket was obviously very tender. How long you cooked it? 14 hours?
14 hours.
It should be fun. It's exactly 14 hours worth of, I mean, I cook on a Traeger personally, but this is amazing. I couldn't do it on the way today.
Bring the liquor
there.
All right, seriously, but the brisket and everything in the combo
sauce.
And the sauce. What did you think of the combo?
The sauce is unbelievable.
Yeah. All right. Well,
the slaw. I'm not a big slaw either, but I'm definitely eating this and
just this is cooling, right?
Oh, it's great.
Yeah.
So I actually enjoyed it and they did an awesome job. And I love the spicy white sauce.
The spicy white sauce. Allison, that's yours, right? That's spicy white sauce. All right. Let's choose a winner, guys. So you've had a chance to taste, so get your paddles ready. Drum roll. I just want to clap the golden tom. All right, let's see you guys.
That's a request right there.
You take from here, run for your money.
Yes. And everybody at home, you can get recipes from both contestants on our website, hiddenwantedamerica.com. And tune in on Monday when our fourth finalist competing here in New York City to be named GMA Ultimate Pet Master and win that $10,000 prize. Coming up, we have the Coastal Grandma Fast.